Hey guys, welcome back. It's me, Jacob Norman, here with another episode of Dubious Advice for Hairdressers with Phoenix Salon Education. So today we're going to start things off just a little bit differently than what we usually do. Today, I wanted to start off with a story. So the other day I was working in my suite. New client came in. I've never seen her before. She got my name from one of her friends. She came in with her kid, and her kid was 3 or 4. And usually I'm okay if the kid can sit by himself, if the kid, you know, can watch something on a device, on a tablet, on something like that. However, this person didn't believe in that. This person just brought her kid for a curly haircut. So I block off about 1.5 hours for my curly haircuts. That's a lot of time for the kid not to be attentive. And I usually tell my client, if you're going to bring your kid, that's fine. Just make sure that the kid can be attended to. Now, if you're in my chair, you cannot watch your kid. It's not fair to you. It's not fair to me. And it's not fair to the kid for you to not pay attention to them, for you to just be getting the service and let them run around. Now, this is for a few reasons. Number one is I've got a lot of sharp objects in my suite. I've got a lot of chemicals in my suite, and there's a lot of precariously placed items in my suite. The next time that a client comes in with a kid, a child they can't watch, that isn't well behaved, I want you to kind of flip it on them. Would you take your kid to a kitchen? Let's say you're going to your favorite steakhouse. Would you take your kid to that steakhouse, bring them into the kitchen, and look away? No, why not? So if you wouldn't let your kid just roam about a commercial kitchen by themselves, why are you gonna let them roam about a salon by themselves? I've got on my station about 5 pairs of shears. These are sharper than kitchen shears, and they cut through hair like butter. I've also got barbicide. I've got essential oils that should not be placed directly on the skin. I've got other cleaning materials such as clipper spray and oils that the kid should not be getting into. And I've also got hot tools out. I have actually had a kid roam around, and this was early in my career. I was working for a corporate salon, so there wasn't much I could do. The kid was running around the salon. I had moved from one station to the next because I was double booked. And on the last station that I was working at, I had turned off a curling iron to cool. The kid reached up, grabbed the curling iron, and burned his hand. I'm not saying this to be mean. I'm not saying this to be rude, but the salon is not a place for kids, especially if they're not being looked after. I also let all of my clients know, if you're in my chair, you can't be attentive to the kid. And I am okay as a hairdresser. I am okay saying, you know, I'm sorry, but I can't do the service on you today because you've brought your child and your kid cannot be watched after. I'm not a babysitter. I'm not CPR certified. I wouldn't know what to do if a kid stabbed himself in the eye with my shears. And I don't want that to happen. What does this conversation look like as a hairdresser? So there are a couple things that you can do as a hairdresser to prevent the kids from coming into the salon in the first place. One of the things that I do is I really make sure that my policy is very clear. If you're getting your hair cut, if you're getting your hair done, you don't have time or patience or skills or anything really to watch your kid. You're not gonna give your kid 100% of your attention, which, you know, from the age 8 and below, they pretty much need. So I let the clients know, you know, look, like, I understand that you've got a kid. I'm not shaming you for having a kid, but you can't attend to them. So really make sure that the policy is set in place. Make sure that the client knows that, hey, look, I'm sorry, but we can't do this. Now, if you want to bring your husband, if you want to bring a babysitter, if you want to bring a friend, if you want to bring an older kid to make sure that the other kids don't run around, that's fine too. I just need somebody to watch the kid. Now, there's a new client. There's a client that just had that one circumstance. That's fine, you know, let them know, because it's our job as the hairdresser to really be the professional. Yeah, we'll make it work this time, but please know next time I can't let your kid come in. You know, give them one grace period. It's not their fault that the kid came in. Maybe something happened. You don't know their life and they don't know your life. Give them that chance. Be like, hey, look, next time, in the future, please don't bring your kid with you. Really share your experience, because sometimes the client doesn't know, hey, I've got 8 pairs of shears, I've got a straight razor, I've got these hot tools, I've got these chemicals for the kid to reach. The least baby-proof place in the entire world has to be a hair salon. If this keeps happening over and over and over again, you know, you have to put your foot down as a hairdresser. I've got a few clients that just would not stop bringing their kids. And so I told them, I said, hey, I cannot service you in the salon anymore. So what we will do going forward is I actually have a rate that I come to people and do their hair. I'm going to have to charge you that rate, and I'm gonna have to do your hair at home because you can't find babysitters and you can't find the proper care for your kid. I'm sorry, but it is my policy, it is the salon's policy. I see everybody on these Facebook pages bitch and complain that they're not taken professionally, that they aren't respected, all of this stuff. But the clients sometimes don't respect you and they don't wanna pay your rates and they don't blah, 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 because they don't know. So I want you to kind of flip it, kind of give the same example that I gave today. You know, I wouldn't want my kid running around a commercial kitchen. My salon is less safe than a kitchen because I've got way more chemicals. I've got way more sharp objects just sitting around, and I've got hot tools. There's a few places where your kids can run, and there's a few places that kids have a playground, and just a hair salon is not one of them. So I need you to respect me and not bring your kid, and I'll respect you and give you the best haircut that I can give you and give you the best service that I will give you, because I have 100% attention on you, and I don't have any attention on this kid that's running around that's going to destroy my salon. So in conclusion, you know, four kids coming to the salon, unless it's just your policy, unless you love kids in the salon, that's great. But for those of us who don't, you know, first off, really try to make sure that, hey, there's a policy against kids coming to the salon. I'm sorry, but I have to enforce it. I don't make the rules, I just enforce the rules. That's number one. Let them know that there's a policy. Let them know that, hey, kids are not necessarily allowed unless they're being watched. Number two, you know, if it happens, you know, reinforce that and really be like, hey, I'm happy that I was able to fit you in today, but this may not happen in the future. We really don't allow kids. If this should happen again, I just can't service you. It's not fair to me, it's not fair to you. And then number three, you know, give them a solution. So you've already told them that there's a policy. You've reinforced the policy. Now give them a solution if they just can't find a way for them to get their hair done without having their kids. Say, I really appreciate your business. I don't want to lose you as a client, but because of the policies that are in place, I can't have you bringing your kid again and again. I do have a price and I will come to you, and this is my price. Because of this accommodation, they have to pay. They usually pay a $50 to $100 service fee for me to come out to them. And these clients will pay that because because at the end of the day, people are understanding, people care, people want to respect you. And they understand, hey, you know, my kid's kind of a menace. Hey, my kid is running around a lot. Hey, all of this stuff. And they'll pay the extra fee to have you come to them and get their haircut. It's just sometimes clients don't know what they don't know. So you really have to be the professional, you have to be the expert, and you have to offer solutions. That is our job as hairstylists, and I believe that everybody deserves to look beautiful, and I believe that everybody should be pampered. It's just, there are policies in place at my salon, there are probably policies at your salon, and I just have to enforce them. And I'm sorry, but here's the solution. Hey guys, thanks for watching. So this week was a little slow just because I'm working on something bigger for next week. So sorry about that. But I want you guys to just comment, like, subscribe, send me some love. Tell me what you liked about this video in the comments below. Tell me what you didn't like. I'm always trying to learn, I'm always trying to grow. Also, if you guys can leave me a few questions for some of your favorite hairdressers, leave those in the comments below. I'm trying to get together a few different questions to ask people for a podcast that I'm working on. So yeah. Okay guys, have a great day and I'll see you guys next week. Remember, there's a new education video on Wednesday and there's another one of these on Friday. Bye guys!